Hello everyone, Hiteshwar this side and welcome back to the third episode of Straight Reads, where we will discuss one of the books that we have read in the past week with some random topics that we are going through.
Hey friends, my name is Abhishek. I'll be your co-host for Straight Reads. And before we jump into the topics, how are you doing today, Hiteshwar? How's your week?
A lazy extended weekend I had. खूब मज़े से सोया मैं और क्या खाना खाया अच्छे से मौज की मज़ा ही आ गया.
दैट साउंड्स लाइक द परफेक्ट रेसिपी फॉर अ लेजी वीकेंड. नाइस.
या
इट्स नाइस. आई वाज मोस्टली वेटिंग फॉर माय सोर शोल्डर टू रिकवर फ्रॉम द वैक्सीनेशन एंड इट वाज क्वाइट चिल. आई वॉच अ लॉट ऑफ यंग शिल्ड्रन व्हिच वाज अनएक्सपेक्टेड. इट्स अ ग्रेट शो. Definitely recommend.
Yeah, it is.
Sarcasm. Like loads and loads of sarcasm. I really like that show. And I don't watch a lot of shows. So yeah, you can take that as a recommendation.
Cool. But I have already watched that show.
Not for you. For the viewers. I know. If I watch something, there's a 99% chance that you have watched it already.
Well, that's me.
Cool. Let's start.
Yeah.
All right. So today we'll be discussing this book called User Friendly by Cliff Kuang and Robert Fabricant. I started reading it about 2 weeks ago. Still not done with it, but I finished it about 40%, and that was enough to give us some masala for this episode.
Okay.
So before we start, I'll give you a little. A gist of the book so that when we are discussing the topics, you know what the topics will be roaming around. So it's essentially around product design. It discusses the whys and the hows of product design, but the examples with which the book starts is essentially areas where something goes bad, and but in that bad event, first the user is blamed to be at fault, but then the author tries to take a different look at them and tries to explain how the product might actually be at fault. The design of the product may not be helping the user when the bad event happened. And I would also like I'd also like to quote a line from the introduction of the book, which says that technology should become simpler over time, then it should become simpler still, and then it should just disappear from notice. Quite fancy.
Yeah.
Right.
Very good point though.
It does sound really good that the technology should just mold around us and our activities and empower us to do more instead of us worrying about how to get this thing working for us.
True.
Right. So my first question to you would be, as the book is named User Friendly, what does user friendly really mean to you? When would you say that something is designed in a user friendly manner?
The first thing that comes to my mind when I think about it, ki what is user friendly, is something that is intuitive, something that is clean, that is simple, as well as reliable to work with. I guess जो चीज़ बिना कुछ दर्द दिए आसानी से हो जाए, जो मेरे लिए आसानी से कर दे, दैट विल बी यूज़र फ्रेंडली.
या आई कम्प्लीटली अग्री. आई वॉज अप देयर विद यू ऑन द ईजी पार्ट ऑफ इट, दैट इट्स जस्ट मेक आर लाइव्स ईजी. दैट वुड बी गुड टेक्नोलॉजी, बट देन द रिलायबल पार्ट इज ऑल्सो अ प्रीटी गुड एडिशन बाई यू. If something works really well, but it works well once a month, I don't think it really counts as a good design. good point on reliability.
Absolutely
there.
Right.
All right. So before we jump into topic number two, I'd like to state a little story from the book so that the story will create like the mahal we need to discuss topic number two. Let's jump into it.
Yeah.
All right. So it's the story of an island called the Three Mile Island in Pennsylvania. And they used to have a nuclear reactor plant there. I'm not sure if they still have it. But in the story timeline, they used to have one there. And one day what happened was that in the reactor number 2, things went a bit haywire and the reactor went crazy.
Okay.
The temperatures were going up, and when the users or the engineers there in the plant went to the control room, they saw that a lot of alarms are ringing, lights are shining all around. And of course, they would try to debug the situation. And like when you are in a nuclear reactor plant and things are going crazy, you won't be sitting in a corner sipping coffee. You would be running around trying to fix the situation.
Disaster waiting for happen.
Definitely, right? So one of the workers, he would go to the control panel and look at a bunch of lights, the current state. And he would take a conclusion that the reactor actually has too much water in it. So for a very, very basic design, generally in a nuclear reactor, you would have a core in a certain area. And you would also have water flowing over it. So the water comes in, it takes heat from the core and then goes away. So which would allow the core to stay at a stable temperature while we are extracting energy from it. Right. So they essentially, what they did was that they turned off some of the water valves, the inlets, to, you know, balance out this excess of water. But the problem still remained and the reactor temperature was going up. And after a point, instead of showing the temperature, it just showed a question mark. The equipment failed as well.
Okay.
Imagine the situation in that room.
Really scary.
Right?
Scary,
so,
scary.
What happened was that eventually one person just decided to risk his life and he said, "All right, I'll go inside that reactor area and see what's up."
Damn.
So, yes. So, there is some radiation exposure that you get when you go inside that place where the reactor is. And if you stay there for too long, you can die. Or you can have major, how do I call it, injuries? Not really injuries.
Major health issues, I guess.
Major health issues, let's call it that.
Health issues in the long run, yeah.
Yes. So, but he still decided that, okay, instead of a disaster essentially happening, he would go inside the room, risk his life, and check what is happening. When he went inside the room and looked at the situation, he actually saw that the reactor was out of water. And there was a valve open through which the water was leaking out of that area. And that is why the reactor temperature was going up. Of course, he came back. He told everyone. They fixed the valve and the reactor became stable again. But if we zoom out a little bit, and when they would do their RCA, it's generally a software term, but I guess they would also do an RCA. The first thing would be to blame the engineers there, right? That they were not able to properly read the lights and try to make sense of what was happening to the reactor. But what the author is saying is, it is also the way the control room was designed, which added fire to this disaster. Right? And there are some examples there. Now, so essentially what would be there is that there would be a bunch of buttons and a bunch of lights around them. I'm giving a very simple version of it. It would definitely be more complex than this. So say some buttons, some lights, some labels around the buttons on what button does what. But the machine was beautifully designed. But the people who designed it never really interacted with the people who were going to use it in real world. And that was one factor which added to all this problem. So actually later they found out that the machine could have actually saved itself. It was programmed to control situations like this. It would automatically control the valves. But it was not telling the users that. And that's why everyone around freaked out because of all those alarms and lights. Right? And What even added more to it was that, so some of the buttons would have an LED above them some of the buttons would have an LED below them, maybe an LED on the right as well. And when you are reading that, especially in a panic situation, the person would go crazy, right? And it's very easy.
Yeah, it's all gibberish.
Exactly. It's very easy to take a wrong conclusion out of it. And to add to it, when an LED was glowing red, there were 14 different meanings for it. And 11 different meanings for green. This was their observation. And now if two LEDs are glowing red, now you need to figure out the permutation and combination, what might be happening that these two are glowing red.
if I was the guy working there, I would have just resigned. Like, don't fix this. What is this nonsense?
Yeah, right. But yeah, the thing happened. All right. So, yeah. But let's come to the point which the author wanted to state here. That one, it's not always the user that we should directly go and blame for bad events like these. And second, feedback is very important in product design. If the machine is trying to do something, the technology is trying to do something, the user should be aware of what it is trying to do. If there are any changes being made, the user should be aware of them. Feedback is super important. It's there in nature everywhere.
Yeah.
But a lot of times when we design artificial products, we kind of miss the feedback factor there. And that drives me straight into topic number two. Can you give me a few examples of some badly designed products that you used? And anything related to feedback that you noticed that was bad about those products?
The perfect example for me would be the stickers on an apple or a mango that states it's a specific kind of apple or a mango. Like, why would you have stickers there?
Yeah, those are definitely bad.
It's there to
bad.
Eat. I have to peel it off.
Yeah, that's just really bad. And then whenever you buy like a new bowl or a glass, they would put a sticker on the inside of it. And now you have to peel off the glue.
Why?
Once you peel it off, there is this glue left there. And now you have to get rid of that as well. Yeah, that's a good one. What else from your normal life?
The other one is the USB port that we have in general. Now it is fixed with USB Type-C, but the earlier one was a mess. Oh my God. How many times have I got it wrong? Like, सही से फंसा भी दो, फिर थोड़ी देर में पता चलता है कि फंस ही नहीं रहा है, दो बार डायरेक्शन चेंज कर लिया. कैसे? कैसे?
I would never get it right the first time. Like, I would plug in a USB, it won't work. Then I would reverse it. It still won't work. Now I reverse it again and it works. I don't know who designed that one. It was a pain, for sure. What else comes to mind? Or that's all?
Microwave.
Oh,
I have a microwave at home that has 15 buttons. 15 buttons. I just need 3. Why would you have 15 different functionalities working on it? Just remove them. I don't use them. Like, maan sakte hain kisi ka use ho, but itne button kyun chahiye? Aur sabse mast cheez kya hai? Tum jaise jaise microwave mehanga karoge, button badhte ja rahe hain. It's a feature. Kyun?
Yeah, I guess like jab log microwave lene jate honge, they would see ki haan, is wale mein 30 buttons hai. Nahi nahi, isme 40 hai. Ye zyada cheeze karega for just 500 rupees more. Let's buy this one.
Stupid.
Yeah, that definitely counts. Okay, I have two examples. Let me state those.
Yeah,
First one are doors. How many times has it happened that you go and push a door and it doesn't go anywhere? It's actually a pull door. And you bang your head into the door.
I absolutely hate that design.
So many times, right?
It happens a lot. And sometimes it's not that push or pull is written. But then they still don't make sense to me. I get confused by which is push and which is pull, and yeah. I would do the opposite.
I just like these doors, my favorite ones. On the push side of it, they don't have a handle at all. So there is nothing to grab and pull there. Right? So you, of course, would push it. And on the other side, they have a handle. So you would just, you know, grab the handle and pull it. Those are my favorites. But then,
The problem with that, wo ek side ki hi rahe na fir. You gotta have a pair of different doors.
Oh yeah, they don't open the other side. I guess that's their, problem. Limitation. That if your door only opens on one side, then this design would work for you. But if it opens both sides, that solution won't work for that one. But this has been a huge problem a lot of times. And the second one are these infamous light switches. I see one behind you right now. So
what about them, dude?
What it is a set of buttons, right? And when someone comes into your house, they look at the set of buttons. They want to turn on a light. This does not say anything about how to turn on the light or anything. Right? The placement of the button is not related to where the light is in the room at all. And the same for the fan, same for other things. You don't know what which button will do. And somehow there are these, sometimes there are also these reversible buttons. Like you press one here and then there's like a paired button on the other side of the room.
Yeah, yeah.
That makes it even more complicated. Right, so that's another crazy one. I saw one.
I guess it reminded me of our school. Remember, we had a big hall and there were fans and everything. And it was a pain to find out which fan is turned on by which button.
Yeah, I do. Like you would just turn on all the buttons quickly to turn on all the fans. Yeah, I've done that. And I remember they used to write it on the buttons. They would put F, like F, 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 the one with fans.
Yeah, dude.
Maybe when you buy buttons for your house, there should be buttons with an icon. And you can buy the button with light icon for the lights. That would help a little bit at least. That, okay, this button is for a light. This is for a fan.
I guess hota hoga, but wahi hai ki you gotta pay extra money, then we will like.
Yeah, I haven't seen them.
Jaan do.
At least.
Sahelenge thoda.
Yeah. So one thing which was pretty crazy is I read this another book. It's called Design of Everyday Things. What that guy did was that instead of putting the buttons vertically like this, he essentially created like a map of the room. Right. So if there are four lights in four corners of the room, he would take a switchboard and put four buttons on it in each corner, right? And now each button corresponds to one light. And then somehow he decided to horizontally mount it in the wall. So it looks like a control panel when you look at it, and you know that this corner is this corner, this corner is this corner, something like that.
Yeah.
But even that would be...
Aadha hi samajh mein, but... too much mehnat.
हाँ उसको लगाना
जिस चीज़ में सोचना पड़े how is it user friendly
उसको लगाना और बनाना बहुत ज़्यादा expensive हो जाएगा. But I guess when you walk into a room you would be able to map, okay I'm here and this button is where I'm standing and this would turn on my light, something like that. Yeah, these were a few examples. And feedback definitely is there. I see that a lot of applications and a lot of websites, especially when you click a button, they don't show like a loading thing or something. So when you click a button, you don't know if something happened or not. Has that ever happened to you? Okay. That has happened to me a lot of times. And then I click the button again. And then I click it again.
I found those sub websites fishy. I just don't roam around them. एक बार देख जाए ना ऐसा कुछ हो ही नहीं रहा कि सही में कुछ क्या गड़बड़ है. आई गेट अ ओसीडी लाइक क्या ये क्या चल रहा है ये. आई डोंट लाइक दैट
डेफिनेटली. लाइक दे वुड बी मेकिंग सम नेटवर्क कॉल इन द बैकग्राउंड बट नॉट पुट अ लोडर एंड इट्स जस्ट हार्ड टू सी. देर इज नॉट इन अ फीडबैक अबाउट वॉट इज हैपनिंग एंड दैट ऑल्सो एज एंग्जाइटी आई गेस इन सर्टन सिचुएशंस. ऑल राइट. एंड again, there is this thing in the industry, right? That the product, it's not really functional. It's more related to the form. And that is what a lot of people think of design, right? That what looks better, right? If you ask a lot of college kids or school kids, if you ask them what design is, they would just say the thing which looks better. And in the industry, I think that works, that if a product stands apart in terms of looks, people actually think it's better. So my question would be, have you ever bought anything which just looked different and you thought that, okay, this might actually be a better product because it looks apart from the other ones?
I guess both. I bought a fancy flip-flop and a fancy shoe, and yeah, they look different. I bought an orange ones and they look like just... The flip-flops look like ki abhi main bas Goa jaane wala hun, this is Goa ki chappal. I really like it. But then, theek hai, chalta hai, maza aata hai.
Haan, and logon ko lagta hai ki like aise alag hi comfort aega. But yeah, it's not really there. In college, I bought a mouse, like a computer mouse. And instead of having a smooth back, like this mice has a smooth back, it had like a diamond pattern around it. And everyone would just look at the mouse and they're like, okay, this is good. This is more ergonomic. Nothing really was there. It's just like you have not seen a mouse like that, so you think that it's better. And I guess Apple does it as well. Every year when a new iPhone gets released, every year they also release one new color which sells a lot. So that, say, when you pull out that blue iPhone 12, people know that you have an iPhone 12, you have the new one, because it's a new color.
True.
I think it does apply to the industry, and that whatever looks better actually sells more.
Sells better.
In a lot of cases.
In a lot of cases.
Right? And these things that in smartphones, when these things came in, right? There was this camera which would pop out of the smartphone body.
The number of cameras.
Yeah, also the number of cameras. Yeah, definitely. I think Bang On, that is an excellent example of this. That if you see a phone with two cameras, say the iPhone 12, and then you see the OnePlus Nord with four cameras, out of which two cameras are completely
and the macro
useless.
One.
There is a 2-megapixel macro.
I just absolutely hate the macro one.
And then there is a black and white camera as well, right? A monochrome sensor, 3-megapixel, something like that. Right?
Doesn't make any sense.
But people just look at it. Okay, this one looks different. This one has four cameras. This should be the one I should buy. That happens a lot of times.
एक properly rat race चल रही है इस टाइम खासकर जो 20,000 to 35,000 वाली रेंज में है सबको ज़्यादा कैमरे उतारने मैंने अभी हाल ही में देखा there is one Indian company which was coming up with 5 cameras like dude क्या चल रहा है ये एक telephoto है एक zoom telephoto और zoom अलग अलग बोल रहे हैं like ठीक है बना लो पागल किसको पता चल रहा है
समझ गया
there is a macro there is a normal camera मजाक बना रखा
है yeah this is a trend in industry which I'm not a fan of like if something just looks different it's not instantly better than the other products which have been there from a while
but then users are also to be blamed like we act like chapri boys
They should be.
Kharide hain, yeah.
Equally, for sure. And that is what the companies would sell, right? If the people are buying phones with four cameras, even though those four cams are, those are four very bad cameras, then companies would make it. Right? They could rather take that money and put one really good sensor in that phone. But people would still buy the one with four cameras because it looks apart.
Yeah,
when you're talking on it, people would see that, okay, this guy is serious business. He has a phone with four cameras. and then you pull up with like a phone with only one camera, like this one. And you're like, oh, cheap ass guy has only one camera.
But then there are two sides of everything. And some people might see it as a minimalist thing.
Yeah, for sure. But I think...
How do you think so?
The other one actually exceeds this category.
Yeah, true.
So, all right. And that drives me into the last part of this discussion. This is essentially about how do I say it? It's related to self-driving cars, which is where I want to get to. But before that, I want to again, you know, thoda mahal banana uske liye. So it's about designing for error. A lot of products are designed to function beautifully as long as things are going very well. Right? They would give you proper feedback. There would be a lot of messages. The product journey would be impeccable in a way. But as soon as something goes wrong, it would go haywire. And we can also relate it to the 3 Mile Island thingy that we just discussed. That if there is an error, the product does not communicate it properly to the user that this is the error. And the user does not know his or her options on how to deal with this error. And I would again like to quote a line from the book here. It says that a good designer would understand the human-machine interaction and design to make the edge cases comfortable for the user. They would see humans as they are and design the product for them instead of imagining that a human should be this way and this is how they would be using my product. And I've seen that a lot of times in real life where a lot of apps, right? The error cases just don't exist. Like something went wrong and you can just press OK. Like what went wrong? What do I do now? Do I need to reopen the app?
True. That is a pain in the ass.
For sure. And a small example for this would be self-driving cars. Let me explain. So the basic rule is that the car needs to, when it is driving itself, it needs to maintain a basic level of trust with you. You should be able to see what the car is seeing on the screen. You should know what the car is going to do. So on the map or on the screen, you should be able to see that the car will take a left and then you can gauge it, right? Okay, the left is actually not there. Maybe I should take over. And the car should clearly tell you when the car is in control and when you are in control. This basic level, let's see, it has this. But what happens in that one edge case when something goes bad? And I think that is what really matters for these self-driving cars. I would give you an example. There is this case of one Tesla. It was a really bright day and a white truck started to, you know, change its lane and come into a Tesla. But it was not able to differentiate the white truck from the bright sky. And it did not move. And it also was not able to tell the user was just chilling in the car. Right? So what happened, I think cases like this, how self-driving cars handle these, would be the real place where design would come in. Designing for the error would essentially result in a person living or not living in that edge case.
True.
What do you think about that?
I
one
resonate with you. I guess ज़्यादातर केसेस तो अभी हमारे सॉल्व हो चुके हैं. जैसे हम अब अगर फोकस करें सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार्स के बारे में, इट्स नॉट अभी ऐसा तो नहीं है कि सेल्फ ड्राइविंग पूरा अलाउड हो गया. मतलब दे कैन कम्प्लीमेंट यू इन ड्राइविंग, तुम्हें बताते रहेंगे जस्ट इन केस कुछ प्रॉब्लम आती है, उस केस में तुम्हें खुद हैंडल करना पड़ेगा. वो वाली चीज़ है और कहीं ना कहीं सिस्टम भी हेल्प करते हैं. आई गेस धीरे धीरे हम उस लेवल पर पहुँच जाएंगे, स्पेशली इन सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार्स. The other day I was watching a video, एक random video थी जिसमें ये था कि बहुत सारी Tesla की accident avoidance वाली video थी. उसके अंदर क्या था कि गाड़ियाँ चल रही थी and just like you said कि एक truck ने एकदम से left turn ले लिया या right turn ले लिया and driver was not able to figure it out, but the car system was able to. एंड उसने उसको लेफ्ट या लेफ्ट साइड पर थोड़ा और एक्स्ट्रा सरका दिया ताकि द कोलिजन कुड बी अवॉइडेड. तो आई गेस एक तरफ तो हम उस लेवल पे पहुंच रहे हैं, बट अभी वहाँ पे नहीं पहुँचे. अभी तो वैसे भी सेल्फ ड्राइविंग कार्स कहाँ अभी लीगल हैं. आई डाउट कि दे आर लीगल एनी वेयर
फॉर श्योर.
बट आई एग्री विद यू कि यूजर से ट्रस्ट बनाना should be number one priority of any company that is working on these self-driving cars. Like, agar user ko pata hi nahi chal raha, it would be great agar aisa kuch system develop ho jisme user real time mein dekh sake ki side mein uske aaspaas kaun kaun si चीज़ें. ऑल दो आँखों से तो देख ही सकता है बट एक गाड़ी के थ्रू भी दिखे कि गाड़ी क्या देख रही है कि गाड़ी उसको प्रॉपरली एनालाइज कर पा रही है कि नहीं कर पा रही है. एंड आई गेस विद एक्सपीरियंस विद टाइम ये जो सुपर काइंड ऑफ सुपर कंप्यूटर्स जो इन गाड़ियों में आ रहे हैं दे विल बी कैपेबल एनफ टू हैव अ सेल्फ ड्राइविंग बिहेवियर. बट द रियल क्वेश्चन इज कि इंडिया में ऐसा हो पाएगा कभी? देर आर नो रूल्स हियर. How would you drive in India?
India is going to be super hard. Like, if the car is trying to take a turn and some 10-year-old comes on a bike at 60 kilometers per hour and tries to, you know, overtake the car suddenly, the car won't know what to do.
Yes, it will be super confused. Like, kya hua ekdam se?
Yeah, I think
in some of the cases it will save the driver, but then एक टाइम के बाद तो वो भी कह दे भाई मेरे से नहीं हो रहा है, क्यों करवा रहे हो तुम मेरे से.
इवन इलॉन मस्क सेज दैट द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ अ टेस्ला एक्सीडेंट इज 1/10 ऑफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ लाइक अ नॉर्मल ह्यूमन एक्सीडेंट, कार एक्सीडेंट. आई गेस इट्स बेस्ड ऑन सम डेटा बट आई थिंक दिस एंड नॉट जस्ट फॉर द पर्सन इनसाइड द कार, ऑल्सो फॉर द पेडेस्ट्रियंस. You must have heard these cases, right? That there are these driverless Uber cars in some places in the US. And there was a case where a driverless car just ran over a pedestrian.
Oh.
Because...
Ooh, that must have been a big...
And then lawsuit. People look into stuff like these cars are electric. They are completely silent. If you are walking on the road... and a car is just coming behind you, you would have no idea, right? If you are on a bike, you would have no idea that there is going to be a car at the other end of the turn. So I guess then they started adding some basic levels of sound to these cars. So you would see that
too.
Yeah, Porsche has like their own sound, which they like, they essentially have speakers which make a sound in the car at low speed. Stuff like that, because this was a huge hazard. You would have no idea that an electric car is creeping by you.
True. The other day I was on a highway and there was an EV behind me, the Tata Nexon EV.
Oh, wow.
It was problematic. Like, there was no sound of the car behind me. So, in fact, India mein sabse badi problem ye hai ki bahut sari gaadiyan is tarah se design nahi ki gayi hain ki वो सारे के सारे ब्लाइंड स्पॉट कवर कर लें. तो देर आर लॉट ऑफ ब्लाइंड स्पॉट इन दोज कार्स. एंड जब इस तरह से कोई साइलेंट कार आस पड़ोस से निकल रही होती है तो यू गेट टू बी एक्स्ट्रा विजिलेंट कि क्या चल रहा है ये.
डेफिनेटली लाइक यू हैव टू बी
यू गॉट टू हैव सम
इवन मोर केयरफुल इन केस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक कार्स राइट बिकॉज
ट्रू
यू कांट हियर देम स्पेशली एट वेरी लो स्पीड्स. या दैट वाज एसेंशियली द last point that I wanted to come to.
Okay.
We have finished it in almost 30 minutes this time.
Oh,
I guess.
Awesome.
I guess we are making it more crisp. Doing a good job at it. Or maybe it's just me saying good things about us. We are actually not doing a good job at it.
So, what's the summary of today's book review?
I would like to put forward a very user-friendly summary of this book. That
yeah, I really hope you do.
The main points I would like to focus on is that I would take away from the book that you should design for the edge cases where errors would happen. Do not forget about them. And in case something happens, it's not always the user which is at fault. It's also the product. A lot of times I've seen that if the computer doesn't work, I've seen people saying that, okay, I don't know how to use this. And I'm really bad at using a computer, working with a computer or a smartphone. But it's actually also the smartphone and the applications which are not designed to really work well. It's not always the user. And I'm very excited to finish the rest of this book, and I guess we would know more about it in the coming episodes.
Yeah, I guess from my point of view, the day you are able to teach the last generation about something without with just handing them over the product and let them figure it out, and if they are able to figure it out, it is user friendly.
Yeah, for sure. If you hand over like a Windows computer to a child, sure they would have no clue what to do with it. And
yeah,
a Mac, I don't know, but I think a Mac would definitely be slightly easier.
Yeah, I agree.
Relatively, because things are a little less cluttered on a Mac. You have less options, which makes it easier to use. Windows, the menus and everything is just cluttered with so many options.
I guess it's the same problem with open source software, a lot of them. Just look at Linux. Ab tu yehi baat keh raha hai na ki 5-year-old or 6-year-old, just hand him over a Linux system, he will just break the screen. There is no use of that thing. Useless. It's not user-friendly at all.
Yeah, it's been a long time I used a Linux desktop. Maybe I heard there were some really good improvements with the last version. Maybe I should try it again.
Yeah, there are, but it's not up to the level of a Mac.
All right.
And Mac is ever increasing the...
Yeah, it gets better. All right. That's it about the book, actually. And let's move into our next segment. And this time we have a name for the segment. Do you want to reveal the name?
Yes.
So for the random section, where we used to talk about a few random topics from our life, we were discussing that we should name this. And the name is?
So we are going to call the random section the Straight Masala.
Oh-ho. It's going to be full of masaledar topics. Which are not related to books, but definitely related to general life things. Oh, so what do we have on our plate today
around all of us.
For Straight Masala?
So the first topic of discussion is about fiction versus non-fiction. Like, let the viewers know that I am a fiction guy and Abhishek is a non-fiction guy. I really like reading.
What is a non-fiction books. Guy?
Non-fiction guy, I guess, is someone who reads a lot about experience of different people. I guess isme bahut cheeze aa sakti hain, but as per your agar dekho as an example deke chale, so you are the person who want to read a lot about the experiences of different people, and I am the kind of person jisko jo cheeze possible nahi hai world mein kuch ek फैंटेसी वाले वर्ल्ड में रहना ज़्यादा पसंद.
Why don't you give us a few examples of it? Maybe that will help us understand it to a deeper depth. What the hell? Deeper level.
About what exactly?
Why do you think that you enjoy fiction more than reading non-fiction?
Yeah. मोर इन्वॉल्विंग, लाइक तुम रियल एक्सपीरियंस में अगर एक बंदे से रिलेट कर रहे हो तो रिलेट कर रहे हो, अगर रिलेट नहीं कर रहे हो तो इट गेट्स अ लिटिल बोरिंग. बट व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ड्रैगन्स, अबाउट बिग गन्स जो पॉसिबल नहीं है दुनिया में, और अ सिनेरियो जो कि इन जनरल पॉसिबल नहीं था, बट अब इमेजिनेशन तुम्हारी एंडिंग है. लाइक जहाँ तक तुम इमेजिन करोगे वहाँ तक तुम जा सकते हो. वो वाले सिनेरियो में इट फील्स more involved, and I really like the feeling of being part of that fantasy, I would say.
I do agree with that, actually.
That's the thing. Yeah, that's a big thing missing from non-fiction category, I guess, because tum ek bande ke personal experiences pe baat kar rahe ho. I really believe कि बहुत ही extraordinary experiences हो सकते हैं, but then एक point होता है, एक foundation होती है जो एक fiction में नहीं है. मान लीजिए मैं कुछ एक deep meaning convey करना चाहता हूँ और मैं उसके लिए बहुत सारे एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी एलिमेंट्स यूज कर, एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी वेज यूज कर सकता हूँ जो जो कि पॉसिबल नहीं है एक मेरे ख्याल से नॉन फिक्शन वाली बुक में. व्हाट आर यू फील्स अबाउट इट?
आई डू अग्री विद योर पॉइंट्स. इट डेफिनेटली रिमाइंड्स मी ऑफ हैरी पॉटर एज अ किड.
माय फेवरेट.
आई थिंक आई हैव रेड द फर्स्ट थ्री बुक्स एंड सम अदर फिक्शनल बुक्स एज वेल. बट या आई डू I would say that these days I am only reading non-fiction, mostly. I was actually thinking about what might be the reason behind that. So, the first thing I thought of is, on a very superficial level, is that by reading non-fiction, I'm learning more about real things and real applications, which I can apply in my life. But then, even fictional characters teach you a lot of things, which you apply in your real life, right? I'm sure we all have been motivated by Ash from Pokemon or some other show in our childhoods. Transformers, for sure. Everyone has learned wisdom from Optimus Prime.
That guy could inspire everyone. Let's be very clear about that.
Yeah, so I was just thinking that...
Yeah.
That point is invalidated now, that you can only learn real-life applications from non-fiction. And I would say... Fiction, especially for kids, fiction might actually push you beyond your boundaries of thinking and make you, you know, increase your intellectual powers, whatever it's called. But yeah, I was not a huge reader, say 2 to 3 years ago, and I won't say that I'm a huge reader now. But I do read. But I think it's also the circle. The circle which got me into reading and where we discuss the books that we are reading. There is always this backlog of non-fictional books which we have. And there is this wish list. And we're all talking about these non-fiction books in this circle. I think that is another reason that... I am a lot into non-fiction and not really into fiction. But yeah, maybe I'll try it out, man.
I have talked to a lot of guys, and what I found is ki jo log fan hai non-fiction ke, what their point is ki fiction is good and everything, but the bigger problem with it is ki in the reality is disappointing. Like fiction mein tum kahin bhi pahunch rahe ho, but you gotta live, right? रियलिटी में तो जियोगे ना अपनी. तुम्हें यह पता तो होना चाहिए जिंदगी में चल क्या रहा है. तुम्हें उस जिंदगी के उस भाव से थोड़ा दूर ले जाती है. वो तुम्हें बैलेंस करना पड़ेगा, अदरवाइज कैसे जियोगे. मतलब एक होता है ना, रियलिटी से कट ऑफ हो जाओगे.
गॉट इट.
दैट इज वन ऑफ द पॉइंट्स दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव पुट फॉरवर्ड इन फेवर ऑफ नॉन फिक्शन, विच आई काइंड ऑफ एग्री. लाइक तुम्हें कहीं ना कहीं तो एक लिमिट ड्रॉ करनी पड़ेगी. मेरे को याद है अभी भी 9th-10th की बात है. आई वॉज इन कितना 15-16 का था. आई यूज टू कम होम एंड वाइल कमिंग बैक टू होम आई वॉज सो इन टू ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स. तो पूरे दिन मैं मस्त इमेजिन करता था कि मेरे सामने यहाँ पे ऑप्टिमस प्राइम खड़ा है एंड साइड में अपना बम्बल भी है, लड़ाई चल रही है, मोच
आई डन दैट एज वेल,
मेगाट्रॉन भी घूम रहा है. या बट ठीक है, इसकी वजह से दिक्कत ये होती थी कि आई वॉज रोमिंग अराउंड अर रोड ऑन अ मेन हाईवे रोड. इट इज नॉट समथिंग यू शुड डू. सो डोंट लेट इट ओवरटेक योर रियल लाइफ.
या सो दोज थिंग्स एसेंशियली स्टार्ट टू क्रीप इनटू योर रियल लाइफ एज वेल, दोज कैरेक्टर्स. इज दैट व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू
से? यस, बट दे आर फन इफ डन इन कंट्रोल. बट अगर लिमिट टप जाए तो भैया.
बट Isn't that true for everything in life?
सपनों में भी. Yeah, then that is.
Do whatever you want, but stay in the limits. But yeah, I don't think.
I guess. I was talking about the thing that मैं बहुत ज़्यादा PUBG खेलता हूँ कभी कभी. So ये मेरे साथ पहले Counter Strike के साथ भी होता था. I used to play a lot of Counter Strike. Like 6 hours continuous अपन मस्त gaming कर रहा है, मज़ा आ रहा है, बंदे मार रहा है. बट फिर जब मैं सोता था ना, मेरे सपने में भी वही दिखाई देते थे. जस्ट इमेजिन हियरिंग अ लॉट ऑफ गन शॉट्स इन द ड्रीम्स एज वेल. या इट इज नॉट फन. So I've now I have limited those things so that ठीक है यार सपने में कुछ और देखो यार क्यों यहाँ पर गोलीबारी चल रही है.
I think again I am not able to decide if I am pro fiction or non fiction. Like I said, the circle I am in is mostly reading non fiction, and we discuss a lot of non fiction. So we always have this list of books that we have to read. We have heard a lot about, so never really looked at fiction. I guess that is what actually happened in my case. But yeah, maybe I'll try out a book or a few. Maybe I'll go back to Harry Potter and try to read the fourth part.
Yeah, it's a good read. It's my favorite.
Yeah, for sure.
I guess in dono mein na koi ek complete winner nahi hai. तुम्हें दोनों रीड करनी चाहिए, हर एक जॉनर की चीज़ें एक्सपीरियंस करनी चाहिए. हर चीज़ का एक अपना पॉजिटिव पॉइंट है, हर चीज़ का एक डीपर मीनिंग हर चीज़ में तुम्हें मिलेगा एक अलग तरीके से जो तुम्हारी लाइफ चेंज करेगा. तो आई गेस जब तक तुम रीड कर रहे हो इट्स अ गुड थिंग, एंड वैरायटी में रीड कर रहे हो तो बहुत ही बढ़िया.
देर आर एक्सीलेंट फिक्शन बुक्स आउट देयर एंड देर आर एक्सीलेंट नॉन फिक्शन books out there.
Yeah, absolutely agree on this.
Yes, for sure. Nice. So one thing I really wanted to talk about, and it's really being hyped these days, is shorts taking over YouTube. So just to give a bit of context, you must, every listener to this podcast or the person watching on YouTube, you must know about TikTok and what it has done to the world and the country. I'm not saying bad things, it's just in general what it has done. And Instagram then copied it. There is something called Instagram Reels. And now YouTube replaced its trending button with a Shorts button. So that as soon as you just open the app, you click on Shorts and then just swipe, swipe, swipe. 15 second videos, swipe, swipe, swipe. And just keep watching them. What do you think about these? What's your opinion? And is it all right for something like this to take place of a major feature in YouTube, which was there from a long while?
I guess there are two sides of it. Number one, वो एक different category है. Although कुछ लोग पता क्या होते हैं, कुछ लोग ऐसे होते हैं जिनका attention span लंबा नहीं होता. Like they could concentrate on a thing for a minute, for maybe 3 minutes, 4 minutes. That's why the average size of a YouTube video is very small. उन लोगों के लिए short is a perfect thing to that happens to YouTube, and they will easily use it. But then इसका एक और चीज़ ये भी है कि एक मिनट में कितनी कंटेंट लगाओगे, मतलब अगर तुम एक अच्छे कंटेंट क्रिएटर हो तो मे बी यू विल बी एबल टू क्रैम इन अ लॉट ऑफ यूजफुल डेटा इन अ मिनट, बट 1 मिनट इज अ वेरी लेस टाइम टू इम्पैक्ट. इट्स लाइक टैलेंट शो चल रहा है, 1 मिनट का दे दो उसके बाद तुम्हें देखेंगे, या फिर ऑडिशन चल रहा है मूवी का तो 2 मिनट का तुम्हें रिकॉर्डिंग करनी है और उसके बाद तुम्हें मूवी में रोल मिलेगा. बट द रियल थिंग इज द मूवी, नॉट द ऑडिशन, राइट?
इट्स वेरी सिमिलर.
तो मैं उसको रियल थिंग तो नहीं मानता. इट्स नॉट अ रिप्लेसमेंट टू व्हाट यूट्यूब प्रॉपर वीडियो इज, एंड या दैट्स माय पॉइंट ऑन इट.
या आई एग्री टू द लास्ट थिंग दैट यू सेड फॉर श्योर, दैट आई फील दैट आई हैव ट्राइड इट. ऑफ कोर्स आई हैव ट्राइड इंस्टाग्राम रील्स, आई हैवंट ट्राइड यूट्यूब शॉर्ट्स रियली. बट say when you watch a good 10 minute long video or a 5 minute long video from MKBHD or PowerDrift, and when you're going about your day or week, if something comes up you can make a reference back to the video, like alright I watched this video, and you also remember that content and the learnings that you took away from the content. And if it is not always learnings, the entertainment value that you took away from the content. You remember some of the characters, some of the plot. But in these stories or reels or shorts, I feel that you really enjoy that 1 hour, 2 hour of swipe, swipe, swipe. But after that, it's all gone. Right? Yeah. You don't really take away much from it.
भी तो आई गेस कोई ऐसा फीचर भी नहीं है जिससे तुम सर्च कर सको कि पुरानी शॉर्ट्स जो तुमने अगर कुछ देखी हो, कुछ काम का देखा हो जिसको तुम
ओ यार
गूगल में या फिर यूट्यूब में सर्च कर सकें, यो अभी तो नहीं है आई गेस। इंस्टाग्राम में रील्स में फीचर है कि तुम एक प्रोफाइल पर जाके उसकी रील्स देख सकते हो पास्ट की, बट यूट्यूब में तो नहीं है अभी।
एंड समथिंग ऑल्सो केम अप व्हेन आई वाज चैटिंग विद अ फ्रेंड यस्टरडे दैट एंड आई थिंक आई हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट एज वेल दैट व्हेन यू वॉच दोज नॉट फॉर एवरी वन बट फॉर अ फ्यू पीपल व्हेन यू वॉच दोज रील्स फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम it might actually be kind of fun that you see these people changing dresses in like aise chutki bajate hue pop 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 and the clothes change and then
you are talking about cringe content.
Cringe bol lo, some people also do it with very high production value. I don't know if that would be cringe or not. And for some
true
videos, say the person is going on a short ride and they would shoot like a quick time lapse or something. Right, some examples are those, and you got the basic idea, right? But say you watch it for one day, and then next day you try it again. You scroll a little bit in the short section, and you watch a few videos. But after a week, when you open shorts, you know, like the basic vibe is going to be the same type of videos, which is going to be in there, and you just get bored of it. And I think that definitely happened to me. Like I was bored of it after a short while. It's very repeated kind of content.
I guess अभी ये बहुत ही अनऑर्गेनाइज स्टेट में है अभी की जो इसके ऊपर काम चल रहा है, क्योंकि इसका सबसे बड़ा इशू यही है कि पहली वीडियो में मैं फुटबॉल के चार बंदे देख रहा हूँ जो कि ट्रिक्स दिखा रहे होंगे, दूसरे में चार बंदे नाच रहे होंगे, तो अभी तो वो वाला सीनैरियो अभी चल रहा है इस पर। बट जैसे जैसे ये मैच्योर होगा कैटेगरीज के बेसिस पे यू माइट बी एबल टू work it just like a proper YouTube video. Abhi to nahi.
Yeah, maybe.
Abhi it's a waste of time.
Maybe, for sure. And another thing,
I guess there is a market for it.
There is definitely a market for it. Like, definitely. TikTok is still booming outside India, even though it was banned in India. So, the market is definitely there. But another thing which I don't really like about it is that I think it is in some ways affecting the attention span of the viewers. Right? After all these videos, even watching a 5 or 10 minute video would kind of become hard for people. They're just used to, you know, watching 25 seconds and just carrying on.
Yeah.
The attention span would get hurt by these. That's what I feel. And
I guess ये चीज़ जो है ये शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए तो ठीक है, बट लॉन्ग टर्म में पीपल विल बी एबल टू क्रैम इन एज मच थिंग्स, पीपल विल अडेप्ट टू इट, और इसे बहुत ही क्वालिटी कंटेंट बनेगा बहुत ही कम टाइम के अंदर।
या इट वुड वर्क फॉर सम केसेस, बट आई एम स्टिल नॉट श्योर, लाइक 30 मिनट्स में कितना ही तुम 30 सेकेंड्स में कितना ही डालोगे, लाइक इंस्टेड ऑफ स्क्रॉलिंग शॉर्ट्स फॉर 1 आवर आई वुड रादर जस्ट वॉच Interstellar का थोड़ा सा पार्ट, बिकॉज देन आई वुड टेक अवे सम स्टोरी एंड समथिंग फ्रॉम इट, बट दैट्स माई पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। बट देन देर आर डेफिनेटली पीपल आउट देर हु लव शॉर्ट्स एंड दैट्स व्हाई द मार्केट इज देयर।
ट्रू ट्रू ट्रू। इससे मेरे दिमाग में एक और पॉइंट आया कि मेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग ये है कि हम अगर किसी चीज़ पर थोड़ा टाइम स्पेंड करते हैं तो हमारी उससे इमोशनल बॉन्डिंग कहीं ना कहीं होती है। अगर मैं किसी चीज़ को 30 या 40 मिनट से देख रहा हूँ तो इट हैज़ माई अटेंशन, एंड वो जिस तरह से मेरे को इम्पेक्ट करेगी, मे बी एक 30 सेकेंड या फिर 20 सेकेंड की वीडियो माइट नॉट बी एबल टू डू दैट एवर।
दैट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू, लाइक इफ अ क्रिएटर इज जस्ट मेकिंग यू नो रैंडम शॉर्ट्स ऑन यूट्यूब और इंस्टाग्राम एंड यू लाइक दो शॉर्ट्स एज अ सोर्स ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट, बट आउटसाइड दोज शॉर्ट्स I don't think a lot of people will actually follow those creators, rightfully.
True.
But when you watch like good 10-15 minute valuable content, I guess you also relate to the creator a lot, and that might be another difference. Good point. But yeah, again, nothing is bad, but The worst thing would be that a lot of people who are creating really good videos on YouTube jump to shorts just because there is so much traffic there right now. I would hate if that happens.
Right.
Like short people stick to shorts, but others just stick to your normal videos. The audience is there as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Message for everyone.
Cool. That's it, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Awesome. So that's it for the third episode of Straight Reads. We hope you enjoyed it. We have tried to improve the audio quality, video quality in this one. Let us know. And definitely give us feedback. Drop your comments on YouTube. And if you are listening to this in other mediums, you can email us. twostraightreads@gmail.com. We'll be continuing to improve on the quality and the content as well. And keep giving you more high quality stuff to watch and listen to. Thanks. Thanks a lot. See you in the next one. Bye.
Yeah. Bye-bye.